आई हेभ बिन डुइङ एट जेफरसन ल्याबको बारेमा चाहिँ टक गर्दैछु. द आउटलाइन अफ माई टक विल बी द ओभरभ्यू अफ द पार्टिकल एक्सिलेटर, जस्ट ब्रिफ इन्ट्रोडक्सन. एन्ड पार्टिकल एक्सिलेटरमा रेडियो फ्रिक्वेन्सी क्याभिटिज एन्ड सुपर कन्डक्टिङ रेडियो फ्रिक्वेन्सी क्याभिटिजको एप्लिकेसन के हुन्छ, र लास्टको टपिक्स भनेको चाहिँ रिसर्च एन्ड डेभलपमेन्ट टुवर्ड्स द डेभलपमेन्ट अफ हाई इफिसियन्ट एसआरएफ क्याभिटिज, मिन्स हाउ टु मेक अ पार्टिकल एक्सिलेटर मच इफिसियन्ट एन्ड बेटर. सुनिया छ होइन सबैजना?
हजुर सुनिए छ.
So the particle accelerator. The particle accelerator is a machine that uses the electromagnetic field to propel the charged particles. It has to have a charged particle to very high speed and energy, means it's very almost the speed of the velocity of light, to contain them in the well-defined beams. So the particle moves in the well-defined beams depending on the magnetic field. Most of these particle accelerators are used in the nuclear physics research. We also call the atom smashers, or radiotherapy, cancer treatment, some kind of ion implantation, biomedical research, and high-powered lasers. And there are many more applications of these particle accelerators. In particular, the electrostatic accelerators use the electric field, and then there is also magnetic, which use the electromagnetic fields and to charge the accelerator. Means there is also the electric field and also the magnetic field. In total, there are about 30,000 accelerators around the world right now, very big or small. Some of them are industrial application, but some of them are very small research lab, and some of them are really, really big research lab. So this is just, so recently I compiled the what are the particle accelerators around the world, which are called at the bigger user facilities, means everybody can do their research. These are the research. So mostly the, if you look at this one, most of the electron accelerator are maybe focused around the Europe, and some of them in China and Japan. We can also see some of those in India, and then, and mostly in US. So even this particle accelerator, you can divide in this particle accelerator into like three categories. Like the first one is the, you can call the electron accelerator, or the cyclotron light source, or storage ring. And the second one, you can characterize at the, like the protons, which is the positive charge one, and the light and heavy ion, and also it's on the cyclotron, because these are also the ions, the big atoms, protons, accelerators. The other one is the future accelerator, which are, the third one is the colliders. Colliders means it smashes two beams together, or the two particles together. Those are a few of them. I'll show the example later on. And then they said there are some of the biggest projects are being, actually that have been proposed, or they are being under construction. So everybody probably already heard about this big, but these are only just for example. Big accelerator is the Tevatron, and the Fermilab, which is the synchrotron collider, which is not being used right now because it's already decommissioned, and they are trying to build another accelerator, which is gonna be mostly the linear accelerator. And the most biggest one is this LHC, Linear Hadron Collider, CERN, which is about like a ring road in Kathmandu, which is about 26 kilometer in diameter. Even the actual accelerator is underground, which is about 100 meter deep into this from the surface of the earth. So basically it's a circular accelerator. And there's one smaller one, but very powerful one is in Japan. It's called KEK. There is also in the US, it's a relativistic high in ion collider in the US. And then this one is actually hosting the next big electron ion collider in the United States. These are the all circular collider. And then one of the things we need to emphasize here is these are the circular colliders only use these are superconducting magnets. Very high power superconducting magnet actually can guide these beams along the circle. And the other kind of particle accelerator are the linear accelerator, which in linear means in a sense that they are in the straight line. So beams starts from one side and goes to the other side. I just give you some example. This is where I work. Jefferson Lab. That is another one in the AXIA field. It's called European Free Electron Laser. And this is in Europe. This is the FRIV. This is the real isotope production facility, and it can also do more nuclear physics research. And then this one, the last one here, I just showed this one as an example, is the SLAC. It's a Stanford, located in the Stanford, which is, this is the linear accelerator. And this is the last two are currently being constructed. And then the upper, these two are actually been working right now. So. And then the example for this one is that we need to very carefully about this. The linear accelerator use the RF cavities. RF means radio frequency cavities. We're gonna go on details later on, but this one just an example. So we have a two kind of accelerator, one circle. Also, you can also have like synchrotron facilities or a cyclotron. Those are the small scale, but the bigger scale are the colliders, which are in the circle, and also in the, these are the linear accelerator. Just to give you what is what I'm currently working at, it's a Jefferson Lab, which is the electron accelerator. Basically, you can see this. This is the Google. This is just a picture taken from the sky. So, if you see this dotted line, there is a tunnel underneath this dotted line, which is about 1.5 kilometer in the total length, and where the electrons starts from. This position where you use the electron call injector, these goes through this on inside the tunnel. We have this superconducting cavities. We're going to go that on details later on. So this goes around, and you know that the magnets are used to bend it, because magnet cannot just accelerate it forward, because this superconducting cavity use the electric field that can accelerate, but here we use a magnet to bend these beams. And on this side, it also we have this linear accelerator, and it's just gonna increase the energy of that electron beams. And then this goes around and around and around. It can go about five times at Jefferson Lab, depending on what's the energy you wanna have from those electrons before it goes to this experimental hall. So inside this experimental hall, there you can do the nuclear physics experiments. Just to look at the Jefferson Lab is the one of the first accelerator facility used the superconducting radio frequency cavity technology. It was constructed started construction in 1988 and took several years. About more than 200 experiments were already conducted using these facilities. The one experiment usually takes, sometimes it might take a year to finish it. The interesting fact about this lab is that about one third of all nuclear science PhD awarded in the US are based on the Jefferson Lab research. And then because we are also very good, big part of this lab, because more than one dozen of students from Nepal already got their PhD based on the research done at Jefferson Lab. And I can also see some of them here. Tamayarko janale hamro snippet rakhnu bhayo cha. एक दर्जन भन्दा ज्यादा बढीले चाहिँ पीएचडी गरिसक्नु भने करेन्टली एक दर्जन अबाउट वान डजन स्टुडेन्ट्स आर करेन्टली वर्किङ टु वर्स पिएचडी अन न्युक्लियर फिजिक्स. सो अलरेडी नेपाली 20-25 जनाले पिएचडीको लागि एक्सपेरिमेन्ट गरिसक्नु भएको छ, गर्दै हुनुहुन्छ अथवा गर्दै गरिसक्नु भएको छ. सो लेट्स गो ब्याक टु दि अन्डर ग्रेजुएट फिजिक्स. जस्ट टु गिभ एन इक्जाम्पल, electric field and magnetic field are to do, these two are related with this Maxwell equation. Basically, gives you the when there is electric field, there is a magnetic field. And then the one of the main important parameter is the E, which is the electric field or the is given by the voltage divided over the distance. If this in just like in the case of the capacitor. So what we are saying here is the. Now, if you want to get some electric field or the electrical energy in the charged particles, you need to have a really, really high energy. So the way you can make this high energy is not from the DC field, because DC field is really limited. So only way you can do is the in the RF cavities of the RF field. So let's, for example, here, the Lorentz force is the force experienced by the charged particles or the moving charged particles. So we have the Q field, Q, X, E, and also have the electric field and the magnetic field. So the accelerating cavity needs to provide an electric field E in the longitudinal way, just with the velocity of the particle. So that means it needs to go forward. That's why it gets the acceleration and again the energy. And then here, the magnetic field only provides the deflection, but no acceleration. So we have to have this RF cavity in such a way that it can provide the good acceleration on the charged particles. And I already mentioned that the DC electric fields can only provide the energy only the few mega electron volt, but higher energy can be obtained only when the energy is transferred from the traveling waves, which call it as the resonant circuits. And then the transfer of energy from a wave to the particle is efficient only when they both propagate in the same velocity. That's what these accelerating structures need to synchronize with the velocity of the wave of these charged particles. So what are these RF cavities? For example, this is a simple LCR circuit. In the LCR circuit, you can imagine these cavities just like an LCR circuit. So these are just the evolution of going through from how do you actually show these cavities just same as the LCR circuit is. It's just the, we have a capacitor and then we have the inductance, and then those are just in the basically, you provide the electric field and also have the B field. The design of this cavity in such a way that the B field does not interfere the velocity of the acceleration of the charged particles. So as we know that when there is a LCR circuit, the only way to measure this the quality of this circuit is by the quality factor. We can also go through the wherever these we calculate this is just a mathematical relationship, and this is just the evolution from it's nothing but it's just the LCR circuit, but these are designed in such a way that these are confined within the one resonant structure, so that provides the high electric field to the charged particles. Just to give you some example about this, basic information about this, the electric field and magnetic field. The electromagnetic modes, which is satisfied this Maxwell equation, and then the electric field need to be along the particle trajectories, and then magnetic field is zero because we don't want to have any deflection in the charged particle. So all the charged particle only takes the electric field and then it's accelerated forward to the with the energy and the velocity applied. So just to give another example, so this is one of the so this is the wave equation solution. So E and B field are perpendicular to each other. So this is one of these cavities. So you may want to ask like why this kind of shape. So there is another, the most design is like electric field need to be maximum and you have to have a minimize the magnetic field. So that's why this elliptical shape, we call it the elliptical shape cavities, are the most efficient structures. If you're gonna have the most energy efficient RF cavities. So the, and then why these one are connected to each other. That means if you look at the, if you solve this wave equation of these inside this RF field, it actually looks like this electric field goes like maximum, minimum, and then this has a high field. Of the charged particle with this cavities. And then these cavities actually is all of this is made from superconductor. Now these are superconducting niobium. We'll talk about that later on. The superconducting niobium cavities. This looks like it's called length scale area when it's about 1 meter long, this one. So the thing we need to measure it, okay, let's say we use a superconducting cavity, then we have to also find out why these are good and then why cannot use just any metal and any cavities? To give you some example of this one, says the so these are the SRF cavities. When there is a SRF cavities, there is a magnetic field, and then also there is a surface current with this RF field, which causes the power dissipation. So which is proportional to the surface resistance. So the power dissipation goes with the surface resistance and the square of the field. And then for the cavity wall, because these are the cavity walls, so we have to integrate over the surface. And also how much energy can actually store in this cavity is given by this formula. And the quality factor, as earlier, we just showed you some LCR circuit is also quality factor with delta F over F gives you frequency. But here, we can also do that thing, but the other way to measurement is to, the quality factor actually given by the ratio of this energy stores divided by the power dissipation. If you do some math, what it comes out to be, here is I highlighted, the quality factor is equals to the, is constant, is this is the constant G, which gives you the volume over the surface ratio, and then and the surface resistance. So basically this constant G is depends on the shape of this elliptical cavity. So the one way to make those elliptical shape cavities, you can have a higher G that gives you the higher quality factor. So you can change the shape of the cavity, but that can affect your quality factor. So the quality factor is the measurement of the, is basically the figure of merit, how good the cavity is. And also the also measures the how lossy the cavity matrix is. And then just to give you an example, if you just use the normal conducting copper or some other metal, the Q will be 10 to the power 4. This is the number. And if you use the superconducting, the Q will be 10 to the power 10. So there is already a 6 order of magnitude higher if you use the superconducting cavities. Okay, then we need to know what is that resistance? Where this resistance come from? Because once you use the superconductor, there should not be any resistance, right? But that is a, let's talk about what happens in the normal metal. So in the normal metal, electromagnetic response, so you have, is given by the complex surface impedance, where you have this real part and the imaginary part, resistance, the reactance part. But in normal conductor, it just follows the simple formula of the Duré model, which is J equals to sigma. And then from here, you have this skin depth, and then you get the calculation of about the surface impedance, you have this two terms. But that is only valid only in the local limit. But if you don't have local limit or you have very low temperature, because this structure will be running at a low temperature, the temperature low in a normal conductor in a sense that the, when you have a RF field, a lot of power will dissipate. A lot of power dissipate work. And at the low temperature, when you have the low temperature, you can just cool down this structure with something else. So for normal conducting, you can use just cool water. And for the superconductor, we have to use cryogenic, which is liquid helium. So in the normal conductor, in the anomalous limit, this J equals to sigma E does not valid anymore. And in this case, the surface resistance takes the different values. Here, the surface resistance is like omega over square root of omega. Now at low temperature, it does not take, it takes the omega over 3/2. So that means this structure depends on the what is the RF frequency. So in even in the normal metal, the surface resistance depends on this, the frequency. So what happens in the superconductor? As I already told you that these superconductors are free of power only in the static field and only the DC field. But in the RF field or the AC field, they are not a zero power dissipation, because in microwave field, the time dependent of the magnetic field in the penetration depth will generate the electric field. So that's electric field due to this time-dependent magnetic field. And that electric field will induce the oscillation in the normal electrons, because as you know, superconductor doesn't mean everything are in the Cooper pair. So you already have some unpaired Cooper pair, means unpaired electrons. So basically these are the normal electrons. So when you have a DC power, and the static field, the DC current, you don't see those effects. But once you have this RF field or the AC field, we have this normal conduct electrons oscillation with the RF field, which leads to the dissipation. And that is a very simple formula to calculate. Okay, then what is the conductivity? Then the current, you can decompose these into the normal part and then the superconducting part, because the current will be carried by normal electrons as well by the superconductors. So this is just a very simple formula to understand that the for normal conductor, the surface tension is simply the 1 over sigma and then the skin depth. But in the superconductor, actually the surface resistance of the superconductor actually depends on the normal state conductivity. So that's the important thing here. So the superconducting state surface resistance, once we think that in the DC field, we believe there is zero resistance in the superconductor, but actually not. In the RF field, it all depends on proportional to the normal state conductivity. So let's go a little forward. So I said, so the RS is proportional to the sigma n, which is the normal state conductivity, and this is the superconducting state. Superconducting state is it depends on this penetration depth, which is the superconducting penetration depth. And normal state is proportional to this, the gap, because now you have this superconducting quasi-particles, and then there is a superconducting gap. Then in this case, the surface resistance in the superconductor due to the RF field is proportional to the omega square. Now, in normal conductor, at low temperature is omega over 2/3, and superconductor, it depends on the frequency. And then you can also say, okay, well, if there is DC field, means RS is zero. So that goes back to the normal. So when you have DC field, you're talking about the DC field, then there is no surface resistance, then that's the superconductor we first think of. And then more details, Mathis Bardeen developed the theory based on the VCS theory, where he gives it the basic, much more complex surface resistance, because it also depends on this frequency, depends on the penetration depth and conductivity, superconducting gap, the temperature. So these are the more details. So we're not gonna go to that details. Right? So let's just rewind a little bit. So normal versus superconductor. So what is normal conductors? There is some skin depth. We have to talk about the skin depth, which is proportional to the square root, 1/√ of omega. Now surface resistance goes from like frequency dependence, 1/2 to 2/3. But in case of superconductor, the surface resistance is even stronger with the frequency. So we think that there is a benefit about the superconductor, but the surface resistance goes the square of the frequency compared to the normal conducting. But I'm sorry, still, if you example, if I look at the copper at 300 Kelvin, which is normal conductor, the surface resistance will be about 8 milliohms. But if you look at some superconductor at 2 Kelvin, because you don't get a superconductor if you don't go to 2 Kelvin or below 9.2 in case of niobium, the surface resistance is 7 nanoohms. So you can already see the difference between this. So using the superconductor, even its frequency is goes to the square of the frequency. But you remember how the power dissipated, that means it depends on this resistance. So this, and then another thing about the superconductor is, this resistance is within the first 100 nanometer on the surface of the these cavities. That's why it's really, really, really important to precisely characterize those inner surface of these cavities, which is about 100 nanometers. That's what everything is defined by. So these are the some of the examples of these superconducting cavities. These are from the Jefferson lab. We can make those from the scratch. And then we have to characterize and try to make the most efficient structure that can be used in the modern particle accelerators. So these are made from niobium, and then the shape and size varies depending on the application, what kind of application we're trying to do. So that's why some of those cavity actually looks a funny shape, but that's funny. It doesn't mean that they are funny, but it's, they have some special applications. And then for that special application, the shape has to be like that. So, so why niobium? I already told the that niobium is the superconductor with that the transition temperature is 9.2 Kelvin. Another thing is highest critical field means SC equals to 200 millitesla. If you know, the superconductor does not like magnetic field. When the magnetic field is increased, at some point the superconductor tinker properties goes down. So that's the SC, the field at which the superconductor goes from Meissner effect to the mixed state. But these are chemically quite inert, but hybrid it converted with the thin oxide layers, which is not a big problem. These are the materials this can buy, and then we can do whatever we wanted to do at any kind of shape. There are some disadvantages, but this niobium is the most used in terms of cavities where you make the linear accelerator and magnet. We use niobium 3-tin, we dope with the niobium and then the tin, make a magnet, and niobium titanium, those are also made from niobium. So I think the niobium is the most used superconductor in the whole entire world so far. So this is just to give you a brief example about why there is so many high temperature superconductor, why you are using the niobium, which is niobium was discovered in 1930, but we still using this niobium. There are so many high temperature superconductor, like 123 Kelvin, but we still use the niobium and we think this is the one of the best one, and then I don't think anyone can replace it because it's still the material of choice. Niobium with the S-wave superconductor. If you know, S-wave means you have the isotropic gap. And but these all the high TC superconductor are P, D, F, and there are so many, even some of them even quite not sure what a kind of gaps there exist. And then also they don't have the symmetric gap. So if you don't have a symmetric gap, you're gonna get a higher surface resistance. So the best way to do it is, okay, just stick with this niobium. You can find any amount. Superconducting property is very well defined. And for the high temperature superconductor, the properties hasn't been fully understood. Okay, so the first summary one, superconducting radio frequency cavities provide the accelerator to the charged particles. And these are dissipate low power compared to normal conducting. And these cavities always kept in the liquid helium, which is about from 2 to 4 Kelvin. And then niobium is the material of choice to fabricate the SR cavity using particle accelerator because these are can find many, many kilograms. And also these are the best because of this isotropic superconductor. High TC superconductor are not isotropic. Okay. So the first part is just introduction about the cavities. The second part will be what I have been doing at Jefferson Lab. We already told you that Jefferson Lab has the nuclear physics, but I work in the condensed matter of the superconductivity group because we are responsible to use our technology to this machine, to the particle accelerators. So if you need something, we help them. If we need to improve the performance, we help them. And then we also have the different lab around the world and the United States. If they need any of these cavities, we can make them for them. And then if they need any help, we can also provide. So basically this is our national lab. National lab, what the national lab does is like help other national labs. So that's why our research group is the just to make a, how to make these superconducting cavities better. So basically, if you look at all this graph or all the literature or all the test book is always says it plots these accelerating cavities, plot quality factor as a function of accelerating gradient, and then this accelerating gradient is proportional to the magnetic field, because this is the RF field we're talking about. So whenever there is an electric field, there is a magnetic field. The electric field, it can sustain to the higher amount, but the magnetic field is the showstopper, because the magnetic field at some point is going to kill the superconductivity. So usually when you have this quality factors, it's sometimes it provides that some accelerating gradient, and it starts to go down because there's so many defects, contamination, everything on these cavities. So the idea behind this our research is to why can't we make just go all the way straight? Why does it have to go all the way down? Because experimentally, this is the theoretical curve. So theoretically, for niobium, this should go to 50 megavolt per meter, because 50 megavolt per meter corresponds to about 200 millitesla, where it goes from superconductor to the mixed state, means your magnetic field starts to penetrate into the superconductor, and superconductor becomes normal conductor, as in we call it the vortex state, so mixed state. Theoretically, it's supposed to look like that, but in practical life, it goes like that. So basically, our research is to how to make it much better way. My research is mainly focused into, let's shift it towards higher gradient side, and then also in the higher quality factor. So why this is beneficial means, if you increase the Q, means it costs higher. Q means operational cost. I'll go back to on this, what is operational cost means. Basically, everything comes with the money. And then the other one calls it the increase the higher gradient means it's a construction cost. Means if you have a charged particle, you need to have one GeV energy on that charged particle. So if your small accelerator can provide the same energy, means if you have this short accelerator can give you the same amount of energy to the charged particle, then you can have a smaller accelerator. So, but if you have only like, let's say 40 versus 20 is half. So 40 versus 10 is one fourth. So it's also in the linear accelerator, it depends how long the accelerator you want to make it. I think I have a video at the end of this talk that can apply this one. So how do you benefit? How do you increase the quality factor then? So as I told you, these are the power dissipation. So quality factor proportional to 1/r, and the power dissipation goes to 1/Q0. Means lower the quality factor, more power dissipation. Or more power dissipation means that's called the operational cost. So I'm gonna say, so what is the operational cost? What do you mean by operational cost? Means the higher power dissipation, lower Q leads to the rapid boil off of the cryogenic, because all of these are immersed in the liquid helium. Liquid helium, 2 Kelvin, means it needs more power to maintain the temperature. That means there is a fridge somewhere, it's a cryogenic plant that can deliver the liquid helium to this to cool down this structure. And if this structure is not efficient, means they are hot, and with boiling of the helium, then this plant need to put more power into the cooling power. Basically, that's the run for the refrigerator. Just to give an example, the total, the CERN, which we call the LSC, it consumes the electricity about 1.3 terawatt hour per year. So I just do the small math, this is about $150 million per year. That is not all related to the cryogenic cost here too. But if you're just looking at the Jefferson lab, if you want to run this accelerator at 2 Kelvin, it used $2.5 million just to pay the electricity bill so that it can generate the cryogenic, or it can run the freeze. Basically, to run a freeze, that's the amount of the money we needed. So if we have the rough estimate will give you, if you increase Q by a factor of 2, if you increase this Q by a factor of 2, the cryogenic cost will be reduced by a factor of 4. If you Q goes from 1 10 to the 10 to 2 10 to the 10, and if it costs $4 million, then it dropped down to $1 million. So that's why they basically, the research is focused on how to increase the quality factor here. So high Q means high, minimize surface resistance once again. What is the surface resistance? Surface resistance in superconductor is very complicated. Even though we know that, we think that there is no resistance in the superconducting state, but indeed there is some resistance. The resistance we decompose at the three parts, one we call the BCS, one we call R0 and RAFL. I'm going to explain what are those. The BCS is defined by the BCS resistance in the square of the superconductivity. And this one comes from, I already showed you in the, earlier that the non-pair means superconductor need this Cooper pair, but not all electrons form the Cooper pair. So there is some of this normal conducting electron who doesn't have a pair. So they are just running around to find a pair. So when this RF field so sees those electrons, they can oscillate. And then that causes the resistance. So this resistance depends on many superconducting parameter. Temperature, because lower the temperature, there will be the different number of, basically the temperature defines the number of unpaired normal conducting electrons. Frequency, coherence length, superconducting gap, and so on. The second term is the, we call the residual resistance. If you know the residual resistance means, when you cool down, no matter what, there is no perfect crystalline structure. There is always a resistance in the metal, even in the superconductor. But this is the, only the case in the RF field. We're talking about the RF field, not in the DC field. And also the RFL defines as the resistance also due to the trap flux. Well, the trap flux means there is a magnetic field environment in the everywhere, even in the Earth magnetic field. And those Earth magnetic field will be trapped on inside the superconductor, and then that can act like a, you know, the vortices are the normal conducting cores. So those normal conducting cores start to oscillate in this RF field, and then that causes the resistance. So, so my research is basically focus on these three parameters, how to minimize all of these terms together. But the thing is, if you want to minimize one, the other one goes up. And then if you minimize the two, the third one goes up. So that is always a challenge between these three parameters. The surface resistance, so the, just gonna go briefly on these three things. The first one is the how we minimize the first, which is the residual resistance. We do the heat treatment and chemical and mechanical polishing. So basically the one of the bad thing about this niobium is that the hydrogen, this niobium does not like hydrogen. We call it as the Q disease, means the Q goes down when you have a hydrogen. This is one of these, the SCM images, is, where we, when you cool down this niobium, and if there is some hydrogen on the surface of the niobium, and then this form this very funny structures. And this funny structure actually becomes normal conducting, and then you increase the super, the surface resistance. So what we do is, for this reason is, we heat it, this these cavities, once we make it really, really high temperature, basically it's not really high for this particular case, which is 800 C for 3 hours. This is the traditional way everybody does. My research is involved in that we design the different kind of furnace, which is different than the old furnace. It's called the induction furnace. What it does is we have the induction coil that heats the inside the technique called the eddy current. And basically what we found out that we were able to increase this quality factor by almost a factor of two with this new heat treatment temperature. So basically what we design, make a new furnace, and then heat treat it. In this case, we heat treated at 1400 C. Some of the cases, even we heat treated at 1600 C, and we already see the increase in the quality factor. But to notice here, this side is the accelerating gradient, and then sometimes the accelerating gradient goes down. So you have a trade-off. You can get one thing and then you lose another thing. So the second part of this viscous resistance, we minimize with the material diffusion. So what we mean by material diffusion is one of the experiments we also did. It was a long time ago. What we did is with this one of the elliptic cavity, we heat treated, and then there was a small amount of titanium was diffused into this niobium cavity. And when you diffuse this one, this quality factor is also goes from by increased by the factor of two. So that is also the one of the first example of this behavior in our community, where you can increase the quality factor if you dope this niobium with some small amount of titanium. This is just the theoretical explanation of this one. I'm not gonna go in the details. This is one of the where the theory predict. Actually, we gave the experimental result first, and then the theories gave the explanation later on. So this is actually the experiment has done first, and then the theory come later on. So what it does is, this is something to do with the density of state of this quasi particle when the superconductor is really dirty. To give you the same example, just to look at on the right side, it is not always good to have a clean versus the dirty. In the case of superconductor, the clean versus dirty in the superconducting is we call as the what is the length scale of this electronic mean free path, and then the coherence length. So which one is bigger? So if it is clean, means you have a long coherence length and a small mean free path, and then dirty limits means you have a very dirty, you have a very small mean free path on this normal conducting electron, and then you have this the coherence length is much bigger than this. So for this sweet spot is it cannot be clean, it cannot be dirty. So this is how we play with it. It's like, how do we get in the middle of the viscous surface resistance with the doping? Doping means what you call doping or this material diffusion is you put the impurities inside the niobium. So if you put too much, it comes this way. If you don't put anything, it goes that way. So we have to control the way how much we have to put it inside here. And then I already mentioned in the beginning that it can be within the 100 nanometer on the surface. It's right on the surface. So because it doesn't have to go, because the RF field only penetrate the 100 nanometer on these cavities, because these cavities resonant frequencies in the gigahertz range. So later on, there is other experiment done to do the to increase this quality factor, and then the other experiment were done by this called the doping process, and they use the nitrogen doping technology, and then this actually came out from the Fermi lab. So Fermi lab is also one of the biggest lab where they have they used to have a collider, and then they also have this accelerator. I won't go on their details, but this is just the one the part of the research what you that I already mentioned here. You can increase the quality factor, but you can reduce this accelerating gradient. You cannot get both. The best way to get is, can we get both high gradient and high quality factor? So we use this some kind of technique. What is inside this cavity? Actually, in this particular cavity, we found out there is some kind of defect inside the cavity using this, we call the temperature mapping. So basically, when you do this measurement, we put a thermometer around this cavity, and then the thermometer, if there is a power dissipation, to detect these defects in the superconducting cavities. So the recently we have demonstrated that this actually we can get both if we play with some other parameters. So it's called, we call this technique called the low temperature nitrogen baking. And so what we do is we heat treat these cavities in between 200 to 300 degrees centigrade or 100 to 106 degrees centigrade, and we put a nitrogen inside the cavity, and then just heat them almost like 2 days, so 48 hours. So what happened when you do that once? This is what the typical cavity supposed to look like. So it goes down, and then it's about 40 megal per meter. It's one of the best one. So we did, this has a three different distinct phenomena. Those are, hasn't been fully understood, but that's called, we call low field, medium field, and the high field. So depending on the accelerating project, you want to use low field or the medium field or the high field. So that also depends. So what we did is, after this one, the cavity, we cook this cavity for 48 hours at 120 degrees centigrade without anything. So what happened here, see, these two curves look the same, but we are able to gain this much. Like that's the gain in accelerating gradient. Means we can even actually gain this accelerating gradient from 40 to 46.5. And in theoretically, it's supposed to be 50. So we are almost at the theoretical limit. So what we did is now we put the nitrogen inside the same thing and then cook for another 48 hours. Now we see it can actually go up. So we were able to, we're not able to gain much of the gradient here, but we were able to gain the quality factor. So so let's see what happens when you increase the temperature. So later on, I increased the temperature from 120 C to 160 C. Now I gain the quality factor, but I lose on this side. Means my gradient dropped down from 40 to 30, but my quality factor is by a factor of 2. But we wanted to get both of this. So I want to go up here. How do I go up there? So I just change different temperature. So I did 140 C, let's drop down the temperature. So what I did, where I also gained the overall quality factor, and also that there is no gain, but it's not worse than before. So basically, our research and development is trying to go diagonal line. So we're gonna get higher gradient and the higher quality factor. This is just the one of the example about this looping process. I'm not sure about the time, but I think I'll try to make it short. This is just the doping process, and we use several techniques to find out what is actually on the surface of this niobium. And then the last process, we call this the third RFL, which is called the vortices induced losses. So as you know that these cavities need to be cooled down. So when you cool down, when there is some magnetic field in the environment, those magnetic field will be trapped in the form of the vortices. So these vortices are the normal conducting cores. So inside here is normal conducting. And then basically what it does is, these are the holes. The holes in a sense that all the RF power inside the cavities goes through these holes. So that means we should minimize these holes inside the cavities or the vortices inside the cavities. So to give you an example, this is what happened in the Meissner effect. If you remember, the Meissner effect is when the temperature is higher than TC, all the magnetic flux line goes through the superconductor. And then when you cool down below the transition temperature, the flux will be expelled from the superconductor. That's called a complete Meissner effect. But in reality, there is nothing is perfect. So what happens is some of this flux line will be trapped. And then this is just one of the cartoon about the simulation, what happens to the flux, where does it trap mostly, and then depending on it depends on the shape of the cavities. To give you an example about these vortices is wherever this flux is trapping right here is actually this normal conducting vortices. And these vortices, actually, it start to oscillate in the RF field, and that causes the dissipation. So what we do is we cool down these cavities in such a way that it make a temperature gradient from bottom to the top of the cavity is very big. In doing so, the flux actually kick out from these cavities, and then we can minimize this. We cannot completely remove it, but we can also minimize. So to give you an example about the magnetic field scale we are talking about, so the magnetic field of this due to the Earth magnetic field is about the 500 milligauss. So Earth magnetic field, we already have a 500 milligauss of Earth magnetic field everywhere. So this experiment was done, this black and red dot was done, it 40 milligauss. The bottom one, the top one was done at 0 milligauss, and the bottom one is done at these both of them were done at this 40 milligauss, but what we did is one we have cooled down very slowly, and then the other one is we cooled down very fast. Means whatever the difference between these two curve or these two curve is almost a factor of two difference is the magnetic flux is 40 milligauss. 1/10 of this Earth magnetic field is trapped somewhere in the thing. So that can easily make your quality factor reduced by a factor of two. I just like to summarize this one. Superconductors are the fundamental components of this modern particle accelerator. Among them, superconducting cavities made from niobium provide the maximum accelerating gradient needed for the charged particles to accelerate. Current research is mainly focused on how to make these satellite cavities more efficient and used for the several other applications that benefit the society directly. Some of the technology are the nuclear power production. You can use this accelerator technology rather than using the fusion-fission reaction, which is called the accelerating-driven system. Powerful laser, which are free electron lasers, medical therapy, imaging, and also you can use for the proton accelerator, use the proton therapy for the cancer treatment. Environmental, where we can use this accelerator as a waste treatment. And then the last topic I didn't even mention about is the quantum computer, because in the quantum computers, use the microwave technology. The microwave technology can be 2D or these three-dimensional SRF cavities. One of our future projects is to use this technology to use the quantum computing applications. But I didn't talk about this one, maybe some point in future. So. With that, I'd like to show you this one of these proposed largest ever SRF cavity facility. So this is proposed to build in Japan, but they haven't decided because it's too much money. It's estimated to be more than $10 billion to make this machine. So this will be about 30 kilometer long linear accelerator. And then this actually needs 16,009 cell, means I already show you one of the cavity. The cell means one small structure. That needs about 16,000 of those. So I mean, everybody or all the niobium in the world has to be used. So if some of you probably have already seen it, but I think it's worth to conclude this talk with this 2-minute video. So this is the site in, proposed in Japan. The electron source is going around, and positron source is also going around in the tunnel. So approximately 15 kilometers on both sides. That's the electron and positron comes and collide. So that's where all the SRF cavity is supposed to be. That's yellow section is the SRF cavity section. All those pipings are to cool down with the liquid heliums. And then now you can see those SRF cavities. See, that's provide the electric field to the charged particles. Yeah, that's all. Thank you for listening. And then a special thanks goes to Vinil sir, giving me this opportunity to present in front of this, some of many familiar faces and some non-familiar faces. So thank you so much.
Hello, Vinil sir. Okay, thank you, Dr. Vinil sir. Ekchinai, mero awaz aira cha. Ma ta dherai ber
sunira bhayo. Thank you, boss.
Okay, aba Vinil sir, aunu bhanda agadi, hami thank you so much, Paspati lai ekchoti feri Hari ji le pani bhanihalnu bhayo. Ra hami pahile question answer mai jau, ani tespachi aru kura garaula. I request everyone, those who are interested to ask, afno hand raise garnu hola, hamilai sajilo huncha. फेरि एकचोटि पुष्पजीलाई म अहिले एकछिनमा फेरि धन्यवाद भन्नु होला तर इन्ट्रेस्टिङ यो प्रेजेन्टेसन दिनुभयो लास्ट यसमा अब मलाई झन् फिसनमा पनि फ्युजनमा पनि आउँछ भनेपछि अलिअलि प्लाज्मा पनि जोडिहाल्यो थ्याङ्क यू सो मच सो मे आई रिक्वेस्ट रुद्रजी प्लिज गो अहेड रुद्र काफले आफूलाई अनम्युट गर्नु है जसलाई क्वेसन सोध्ने बेला हुन्छ अनि
पुष्पजी एकदम इट्स भेरी भेरी इन्ट्रेस्टिङ टक मलाई एकदम I learned a lot of things. Mero euta quick question chai, tapaile jun yo penetration depth ko kura garnu bhani, skin depth.
To
skin depth chai, jastai metal ma skin depth is proportional to 1 over square root of omega. Ra tyo usma ta ideally superconductor ma ta zero hudaina penetration depth.
Teti nai farak ke chha bhanda, metal ra superconductor ma bhaneko chai जब मेटल में सुपर कंडक्टर में गई सके वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट इन सुपर कंडक्टिंग लेंथ स्केल व्हिच इज कॉल्ड लंदन पेनिट्रेशन डेप्थ यू नो
राइट सो
द पेनिट्रेशन डेप्थ विल बी डिफरेंट
हजुर भनेको लंदन पेनिट्रेशन डेप्थ र स्किन डेप्थ भनेको त फरक फरक कुरा हो नि हैन र
फरक कुरा त त्यस कारणले चाहिँ स्किन डेप्थ इन नर्मल नर्मल कंडक्टर लंदन पेनिट्रेशन डेप्थ इन सुपर कंडक्टिंग स्टेज That's why the tamale penetration depth the measurement garnu bhayo bhane eta tc ma chai tyaha chai singularity auncha ke tesma garcha experimentally chai singularity auncha kanle
thank you
thank you rudra ji next joy paudel please ma yo sequence mai bolai rahechu hai please unmute garnu hola unmute garna saknu bhayena ke ho
la
सरी दुईचोटि अनम्युट भएछ ल ओके जयजी प्लिज गो
सर सबलाई नमस्कार पशुपति सर म चाहिँ यहाँ टेम्पल युनिभर्सिटी फिलाडेल्फियाबाट ग्रेजुएट हजुर अनि म एउटा समर चाहिँ यो एसआरएफ क्याभिटीमा काम गर्न पाएको थिएँ अहिले त म अक्साइड मेटेरियलमा गर्छु एमजीबी2मा स्यासिङ सीको ग्रुपमा गरेका थिएँ अनि त्यो हामीले एमजिबी2 कोटिङ गर्दाखेरि जस सुपर हामीले धेरै नै 36 केल्भिनको एराउन्डमा पाइयो तर क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर एकदमै कम आयो स्पेसल्ली चाहिँ आइरिस रिजनमा चाहिँ राम्रोसँग कोट भयो तर इक्विटोरियल रिजनमा चाहिँ राम्रो कोट भएन त्यहाँ चाहिँ एल्लोई मात्रै बस्यो अनि त्यो क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर चाहिँ त्यो कुन रिजनमा धेरै कोट भयो भन्नेले डिटर्माइन गर्छ कि युनिफर्म कोटिङ हुनुपर्छ भन्ने चाहिँ मेरो
क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर भनेको मेजर अफ एभरेज हो एभरेज हो त्यस कारणले चाहिँ तपाईँको एक ठाउँमा डिफेक्ट छ भने त्यसले डोमिनेट गर्छ कि यसलाई अहिले मैले त्यहाँ भर्टेक्स भनेर तपाईँलाई एउटा होल भने नि तपाईँको जुन ठाउँमा हायर कोटिङ भएन त्यो नै होल्स हुन्छ त्यस कारण तपाईँको सबै आरएफ पावर त्यहीँबाट जान्छ होइन त्यही भएर क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर लोड हुन्छ
त्यो अब जस्तै टिसी त जस्तो यो नायोबियमको त 9 केल्भिन भन्दा माथि अब अहिलेसम्म जस गएको भेटिएको छैन डोपिङहरूको अनि अब यो म्याग्नेसियम डाइबराइडको बारेमा चाहिँ कतिको इन्ट्रेस्टेड जस भन्नाले यसको अलिकति बढी इन्ट्रेस्ट यतातिर जान मिल्ने हो कि कस्तो हो भनेर
अब मैले इट्स डिपेन्ड अन द एप्लिकेसन व्हाट काइन्ड अफ एप्लिकेसन अब वाइ मैले भनेको लाइक हाई टेम्परेचर एप्लिकेसन गर्ने हो भने म्याग्नेसियम डाइब्रोमाइड हुन्छ र भेरी लो पावरको युज गर्ने हो भने म्याग्नेसियम डाइब्रोमाइड मेबी युजफुल तर नायोबियम इज मेरो पर्सनल पोइन्ट अफ भ्यू भनेर मैले नायोबियम गरेको भन्दा नायोबियम इज द वान अफ द बेस्ट तर अल्टरनेटिभ मेटेरियलहरू देयर आर आउट देयर सो वी क्यान फाइन्ड आउट म्याग्नेसियम डाइब्रोमाइडको लागि पनि यसको सुपर कन्डक्टिङ ग्याप प्रब्लम हुन्छ बिकज इट हेज टु डिफरेन्ट टु सुपर कन्डक्टिङ ग्याप यसको आफ्नै दुईवटा सुपर कन्डक्टिङ ग्याप छ त्यस कारणले गर्दाखेरि देयर आर सम प्रब्लम बट इट क्यान बी डन
धन्यवाद
थ्याङ्क यू जयजी नेक्स्ट हरि पौडेल प्लिज हरिजी
हजुर हजुर राजु सर धन्यवाद पशुपति दाई नमस्कार
एकदम
राम्रो टक दिनुभयो दाईलाई चाहिँ म एउटा दुईटा क्वेसन गर्न चाहन्छु सायद सम्भवतः तपाईँले अगाडि नै अगाडिको साथीले सोधिसक्नुभयो यो प्रश्न यो चाहिँ तपाईँले अहिले नायोबियम सुपर कन्डक्टिङ युज गर्नुभयो यो चाहिँ मलाई लाग्छ यसको क्रिटिकल टेम्परेचर 9 अराउन्ड 9 केल्विन छ क्यारे है अनि त्यो हाई टेम्परेचर त्यही एप्लिकेसनको लागि हाई टिसी सुपर कन्डक्टिङ त्यति युजफुल हुँदैन
हुँदैन दुईवटा कुराले हुँदैन किनकि नम्बर एक चाहिँ आइटिसी सुपर कन्डक्टरको ग्याप सिमेट्रिक हुँदैन ग्याप सिमेट्रिक नभएपछि यसको सर्फेस रेजिस्टेन्स हाई हुन्छ सर्फेस रेजिस्टेन्स हाई भयो भने चाहिँ के अरे क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर लो हुन्छ नम्बर एक नम्बर दुई चाहिँ आइटिसी सुपर कन्डक्टर चाहिँ टाइप 2 सुपर कन्डक्टर हो यसको लोअर क्रिटिकल फिल चाहिँ धेरै कम हुन्छ हायर क्रिटिकल फिल हाई हुन्छ नायोबियमको लोअर क्रिटिकल फिल 200 मिलिटेस्ला हुन्छ त्यस कारणले 200 मिलिटेस्ला नभइकन म्याग्नेटिक फिल्ड पेनिट्रेट हुँदैन र क्याभिटी डिजाइन गर्दा कस्तो छ भन्दा 200 मिलिटेस्ला भनेको अलरेडी 40-50 मेगा वोल्ट पर मिटर प्रड्युस हुन्छ त्यसका दुईवटा कारण भयो तेस्रो कारण भनेको यो क्याभिटीको सेपमा बनाउन सकिँदैन कि अहिलेसम्म टेक्नोलोजी आएको छैन भनौँ त्यसले नायोबियम चाहिँ मेटल हो यसलाई जसरी बनाए नि हुन्छ
अनि अर्को क्वेसन चाहिँ पशुलाई यो जुन प्रोपागेटिङ मोड हो आरएफको चाहिँ त्यो चाहिँ एकदम लो प्रोपागेटिङ लो इन्डेक्स मोड होला होइन 0-1-0
भनेको लोएस्ट मोड मोड एक्सिलेटिङ मोड चाहिँ गर्नु पर्यो त्यतिमा
हजुर अनि यो हायर मोडहरू पनि एक्साइट गर्छ होला आरएफले त्यहाँ अनि त्यसलाई त्यसले चाहिँ क्वालिटी फ्याक्टरमा चाहिँ अलिकति इन्स्टेबिलिटी ल्याउँदैन
त्यो चाहिँ राम्रो क्वेसन गर्नु तपाईँले अब अलिकति डिजाइनै गरेको तरिकाले क्वेसन सुन्नुभयो होइन हायर अर्डर मोड द्याट इज अल द मोड अब तपाईँले वेब गाइड हेर्नुभयो भने द्याट मिलियन छ सबै मोडहरू हुन्छन् होइन 3D स्ट्रक्चर भइसकेपछि र हामीले क्याभिटीको सेप डिजाइन गर्दा यसरी गर्नुपर्छ कि त्यो सेकेन्ड अर्डर अथवा हायर अर्डर मोड त्यो मेन रेजोनेन्स पिक भएको रेजोनेन्स फ्रिक्वेन्सीभन्दा अलिकति पर होस् त्यस कारणले हामीले वी क्यान युज अ कट अफ फ्रिक्वेन्सी त्यस कारण त्यसको लागि हायर अर्डर मोडलाई कट अफ गर्नको लागि अब अरू आरएफ टेक्नोलोजी अरू रिड आउट टेक्नोलोजी अरू बाँकी नै छ अहिले त मैले त क्याभिटी मात्रै कुरा गरिरहेको छु
ओके धन्यवाद मसँग अरू पनि क्वेसन छ तर साथीहरू हुनुहुन्छ पछाडि छलफल गराउँला पुछ्दै
अहिले अहिले अरूमा पनि आउला नत्र फेरि हरिजीलाई हामी रिक्वेस्ट गरौँला नि
हस् सर
ओके नेक्स्ट मेदनी संग्रौलाजी प्लिज
नमस्ते सबैजनालाई पशुपति सरलाई पनि नमस्ते
नमस्कार पछाडि चिने जस्तो लाग्यो
तपाईँले निम्बलमा बिएससी पढाउनु भएको हो हामी बिएससी फर्स्ट इयर पढ्दैथ्यौँ इट पढाउनु हुन्थ्यो होइन म अहिले चाहिँ यहाँ ब्रुकहेभन नेसनल ल्याबमा छु मेरो क्वेसन अलिकति मिन हुनसक्छ होइन यो अब म एक्सिलेरेटर फिजिक्स फिल्डमै भए पनि यो कस्तो भने धेरै यो क्याभिटीहरू सुपर कन्डक्टिङ क्याभिटीहरू देखियो धेरै जसो अर्थात् भन्नु धेरै जसो मैले देखेको चाहिँ त्यो नम्बर अफ सेल्सहरू चाहिँ अड नम्बर देखेँ मैले चाहिँ होइन जस्तै 5 सेल क्याभिटी अथवा 7 सेल क्याभिटी त्यो टेस्ला क्याभिटीहरू 9 सेल्स क्याभिटीहरू इभन नम्बरहरूको चाहिँ देखिएन त्यस्तो केही कारण छ त्यसको पछाडि
छैन छैन छनलाई छैन त्यो चाहिँ हार्मोनिक मिलाउनको लागि इभन र अड भनेको बिचमा अलिकति ग्याप राखिन्छ होइन दुइटा यु क्यान मेक 9 सेल अथवा 6 सेल अथवा अहिले हामीले एसएनएसको लागि क्याभिटी काम गरिरहेको छु मैले अहिले एसएनएस भनेको ओक रिज नेसनल ल्याबको क्याभिटीको लागि सिक्स सेलको क्याभिटी युज गरिरहेको छ हामीले, त्यस कारणले त्यसमा चाहिँ कुनै रेस्ट्रिक्सन छैन। तर तपाईँ त्यो चाहिँ केमा भर पर्छ भन्दा तपाईँको वेभ लेन्थ म्याच मिसम्याच मिलाउनको लागि मात्रै तपाईँको क्याभिटीको नम्बर अफ सेप मिलाउनु मात्रै। तपाईँले 19, 20, 100 क्याभिटीको सँगै बनाए नि सकिन्छ।
ओके अब अर्को क्वेसन चाहिँ त्यो सिमेट्रिक ग्यापको कुरा गर्नुभएको थियो, हाई टेम्परेचर सुपर कन्डक्टरमा चाहिँ सिमेट्रिक ग्याप चाहिँ हुँदैन, एन्टिसिमेट्रिक ग्याप हुन्छ, त्यो अलिकति क्लियर बनाए थोरै एक्सप्लेन गरिदिनुहुन्छ कि भन्ने।
तपाईँ त हाइब्रिडाइजेसन भन्ने थाहा छ नि, एसपिडिओए भन्ने कुरो, त्यो क्वान्टम मेकानिक्स एसपिडिओ एसपिएसको भनेको हाइब्रिडाइजेसनको गर्दाखेरि स्फेरिकल हुन्छ, अनि पी गरे भने चाहिँ यता के अरे नोड हाम्रो निर्मलजी हुनुहुन्छ उहाँले चाहिँ राम्रोसँग भन्न सक्नुहुन्छ होला, नोड र एन्टी नोड भएको कारणले गर्दाखेरि यसको सिमेट्रिक ग्याप हुँदैन। त्यस कारणले चाहिँ ग्याप भनेको त ग्यापबाट टनलिङ गर्नको लागि मात्रै नै हो नि, किसिमको क्वाजी पार्टिकलहरू कसरी टनलिङ गर्छ भन्ने कुरा, जहाँ सानो ग्याप छ सानोसम्म टनलिङ हुन्छ, ठुलो ग्याप छ ढिलो टनलिङ होला, अन्त मोर इनर्जी लेभल चाहियो होला, त्यस कारणले आइटिसी चाहिँ युजफुल हुँदैन। र आइटिसीको लागि जुन एउटा सर्टन फ्रिक्वेन्सीले मात्रै काम हुँदैन, यसको फ्रिक्वेन्सी डिपेन्डेन्स कम्प्लेक्स हुन्छ, त्यस कारणले चाहिँ सर्फेस रेजिस्टेन्स 3 times हायर देन नाइरोबियम हुन्छ। त्यस कारणले 3 times हायर सर्फेस रेजिस्टेन्स भनेको क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर, 3 times लोअर।
थ्याङ्क यू मेहनजी, तपाईँ त अहिले पनि एक्सिलेटरमै हुनुहुन्छ जस्तो छ, तर ब्याकग्राउन्ड इमेज रहेछ। त्यही त होइन, भर्चुअल नै राख्नु पनि कतिको माया गर्नुहुन्छ देखियो नि, सो
नाइस।
रिलेटिभिस्टिक कति इनर्जी हुन्छ यसमा, आयन के आयन हो?
अहिले चाहिँ हामीले यहाँ रन गरिरहेको चाहिँ गोल्ड आयन हो सर, गोल्ड आयन कोलिजनहरु गराउँछौं त्यहाँ।
हामी त हिलियमदेखि नै हेभी भन्न सुरु गर्थ्यौँ, गोल्ड पुगेछ है। ओके, अनि इनर्जी कति जति हुन्छ त्यसको?
अहिलेको एनर्जी चाहिँ मलाई सम्झना भएसम्म 7 GeV को कोलाइड गरेको मलाई अहिले तत्कालको अपरेसनमा चाहिँ त्यो छ सर। कतिसम्म जान्छ भन्न सकिन, गोल्डकै
गर्न
सकिन्छ
यसलाई हाम्रोमा
इलेक्ट्रोन 12 GeV जान्छ अरे,
तर यो चाहिँ हेभी रहेछ। ओके, नेक्स्ट शम्भु घिमरेजी प्लिज।
नमस्ते सबैजनालाई, पुष्पजी एकदम राम्रो टक
दिनुभयो। नमस्कार।
प्रश्न दुईटा, एउटा चाहिँ स्कोपको बारेमा, अर्को चाहिँ अलिकति टेक्निकल क्वेसन हो है। यो स्कोप चाहिँ जस्तो स्पेसली यो जुन यो जापानिजहरूले बनाउन लागेको कोलाइडर देखाउनु भयो नि जुन, त्यसले चाहिँ के गर्न खोजेको उनीहरूले, जस्तो अब एलएचटीमा गर्न नसकेको कामहरू जापानिज कोलाइडरले चाहिँ उनीहरूले के गर्न खोजेका छन्, एउटा स्कोप। अर्को चाहिँ यो टेक्निकल, जस्तो जुन यो तपाईँले चाहिँ यो मिडियम लेभलमा चाहिँ तताउँदाखेरि, बिस्तारै तताउँदाखेरि फ्याक्टर चाहिँ राम्रो भयो भनेर भन्नुभयो नि, त्यो चाहिँ त्यसको अन्डरलाइङ फिजिक्स के हो? जस्तो अब हामीले भात पकाउँदाखेरि चाहिँ अब मन्द आगोमा पकायो भने मिठो भएको जस्तै हो कि
के अरे? ल, पहिलो कुरा त एलएससी र आइएलसी छुट्टै ऊ हो, त्यो एलएससीमा चाहिँ आयनहरू कोलाइडर हुन्छ, त्यहाँ चाहिँ इलेक्ट्रोन पोजिट्रोन कोलाइडर हुने हो, र इनर्जी लेभल इनर्जी स्केल चाहिँ फरक छ उसको र उसको भन्दा, त सर्कुलर कोलाइडर भर्सेस लिनियर कोलाइडरमा, त्यो चाहिँ 500 GeV अहिले ओरिजिनल प्लान गरेको छ, त्यसको लागि लामो मात्रै हुँदै जान्छ, त्यो चाहिँ फिजिक्स ब्याकग्राउन्डको लागि मात्रै हो। मेरो भनेको चाहिँ हामीले यदि कन्स्ट्रक्सन भइहाल्यो भने वी हेभ टु प्रोभाइड द्याट 16,000 क्याभिटिज, त्यो चाहिँ कुरा हो। अब अर्को चाहिँ तपाईँले मिडियम के भन्नुभयो भन्दा, मिडियम इनर्जीको क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर र हायर इनर्जीको क्वालिटी फ्याक्टर भन्नुभयो होइन तपाईँको। फर इक्जाम्पल, अब त्यही LCLS2 को इक्जाम्पल दिन्छु म तपाईँलाई। LCLS2 चाहिँ अहिले मसिन रन हुने भनेको 16 MVA पर क्याभिटीले 16 MVA ऊ गर्नुपर्छ, तर 16 मात्रै त होइन, किनकि हामीले 40-50 पुगेका छौँ, किन 40-50 गऱ्यो भने त लाइक फर इक्जाम्पल 32 गऱ्यो भने त्यो तपाईँको भएको एक्सिलेटर हाफमा ल्याउन सकिन्छ नि, र एक्सिलेटर दुईवटा मोडले रन हुन्छ, एउटा चाहिँ एउटा कन्टिन्युस वेभ मोड भन्छन्, त्यो भनेको कति भन्दा इलेक्ट्रोन किप मुभिङ अल द टाइम, त्यसको लागि क्याभिटीले इनर्जी प्रोभाइड गरेको गर्नु पर्यो। अर्को मोड भनेको चाहिँ पल्स मोड भन्छ, पल्स मोडमा चाहिँ क्याभिटी र एकचोटि सिङ्क्रोनाइजमा एकैचोटि सबै एक्साइट भयो भने चार्ज पार्टिकल वान टाइम मुभ हुन्छ. त्यस कारणले चाहिँ यो आइएलसी अहिले मैले लास्टमा देखाएको मसिन भनेको पल्स मोड हो, किनकि त्यसले चाहिँ when the electron comes, the cavity excites, it provides the energy and moves forward, and then by pasadi ko turned off huncha agadi ko agadi ma lancha ra LCLS chai ke cha bhanda when the machine is running, it's running all the time. So tes karan le garda to medium energy ma chai ramro bhat pak cha to chai kasto lai accelerator bhanda continuous wave accelerator athawa tapai lai FE x-ray chahiye cha XFL chahiye cha to pulse ma aayo ni haina ki continuous wave ma auncha. अर्को कोलिजन भनेको त एउटा गुड कोलिजन भयो भने सकिहाल्यो नि होइन, त्यस कारणले चाहिँ त्यो पल्स मोडमा हुन्छ. त्यस कारणले वी निड हाई अथवा लो डिपेन्डिङ अन द एप्लिकेसन.
भनेपछि त्यो पल्स मोड भनेको अब पल्स चाहिँ कतिको सर्ट हुन्छ, त्यसमा चाहिँ लेजर पनि सिङ्क्रोनाइज गर्न सक्ने खालको छोटो हुन्छ?
होइन, त्यो त के अरे तपाईँको त्यही त्यस्तो चाहिँ अब क्याभिटीको सेप हो, तपाईँको कस्तो क्याभिटीको सेप अनुसार गर्छ त्यस अनुसार फरक, त्यसमा फरक पर्ने. तर ती त चार्ज पार्टिकल हुन् जब इलेक्ट्रोन गोज थ्रु द वाट इज कल विग्लर्स, अनि त्यसपछि मात्रै तपाईँले चाहिँ एक्सरे तपाईँलाई चाहिएको एक्सरे त्यसबाट निकाल्न सक्नुहुन्छ.
बुझ्यो. मैले भनेको चाहिँ के भने त्यो जुन कोलाइडरमा इलेक्ट्रोन र प्रोटोन कोलाइड गर्ने कोलाइडरमा त्यो टार्गेटमा लेजर सिङ्क्रोनाइज गर्न सकिँदै सकिन्न भन्नु खोजे पल्स भएको कारणले.
लेजर चाहिँ चार्ज पार्टिकल नभएको कारणले गर्दा मलाई चाहिँ थाहा भएन. इट्स ओन्ली वर्ड फर द चार्ज पार्टिकल्स.
ओके शम्भुजी.
हजुर हजुर, थ्याङ्क यू
थ्याङ्क यू थ्याङ्क यू शम्भुजी अनि पुष्पजीलाई पनि. अब यहाँ उठेका हातहरू सबै तल झरे, थ्याङ्क यू. तर एउटा यहाँ च्याटमा एउटा क्वेसन छ, एक्सेलेरेटर इज रनिङ भन्नुभएको छ, त्यही भएर त्यो भनेको मलाई सोधिदिनु भन्नुभयो होला विष्णुजीले.
जस्तै यो आफै पनि सोध्छु
नभयो. ओके प्लिज गो अहेड विष्णुजी.
म यही छु र यो चाहिँ कहिलेकाहीँ हामी म इजिप्सन ल्याबमा काम गर्छु र पुष्पत दाईको घरको नजिकै बस्छु म. अनि यो एक्सलेटर रनिङ भइरहेको बेलामा धेरै जसो समयमा चाहिँ एमसिसीले, अब एमसिसी भनेको मसिन कन्ट्रोल सेन्टर एउटा तिनीहरूको छुट्टै डिपार्टमेन्ट छ, तिनीहरूले त्यो मेसिन चलाउने एक्सलेटर चलाउने बिम डेलिभर गर्ने गर्छन्। त्यो बेलामा चाहिँ यो क्याभिटीमा प्रब्लम आयो भन्छन् र दुई चार घन्टा बिम स्टप गरिदिन्छन्, कहिलेकाहीँ घन्टौँ जान्छ र कहिलेकाहीँ कपाल अफ डेजलाई पनि त्यो बिम जान्छ.
मैले देखाइसकेँ तपाईँलाई सानो सानो यस्तो क्याभिटी होइन, त्यस्तो अहिले जेफरसन ल्याबमा हेऱ्यो भने लगभग 350 त्यस्तो सानो स्ट्रक्चरहरू सर्कुलर रिङमा छन्. तपाईँको एउटा क्याभिटीले चाहिँ इलेक्ट्रिक फिल्ड प्रड्युस गरेन, त्यसले केही फरक पर्दैन, इलेक्ट्रिक अर्को क्याभिटीले त्यसलाई उयो गर्छ. तर तपाईँको त्यो एउटा भएको क्याभिटीले इलेक्ट्रिक फिल्ड अर्को डिरेक्सनमा पठाइदियो, स्क्विड भयो भने तपाईँको बिम चाहिँ सिधा बिम ट्युबमा रोटेट नभइकन स्टार्ट हिट अन द सर्फेस. त्यसको कारणले गर्दाखेरि बिम ट्रिप भन्छ. त्यो बिम ट्रिप गर्नको लागि चाहिँ सबै क्याभिटी एउटै फ्रिक्वेन्सीमा हुनु सिङ्क्रोनाइज हुनुपर्छ. एउटै फ्रिक्वेन्सीमा सिङ्क्रोनाइज भएन भने त्यसको पल्स मिल्दैन, इनर्जी मिल्दैन. त्यस कारणले तपाईँको त्यो क्याभिटी डिट्युन हुन्छ. डिट्युन हुन्छ भनेको आउट अफ फ्रिक्वेन्सी जान्छ. त्यस कारणले एमसिसीले त्यहाँ बसेर कन्ट्रोल रुमबाट त्यो क्याभिटीलाई ब्रिङ ब्याक टु नर्मल पोजिसन. समटाइम्स इट टेक्स 1 आवर, समटाइम्स इट टेक्स कपल डेज. थ्याङ्क यू.
विष्णुजीलाई पनि धन्यवाद. फेरि एकछिन है, कसै ओके कसैको छैन. थ्याङ्क यू सो मच. अझै पनि कसैको केही क्वेरी छ भने वी क्यान स्टिल आस्क, एल्स आई विल रिक्वेस्ट हेड सर इफ इज हियर. कसैको केही छ? मेरो पनि एउटा छ है सानो.
हजुर हजुर.
ए यो हाम्रो अनिस दाहालजीले भन्नुभएको छ, मैले भनिहाले उनीहरूले फेरि के होला भन्ने होला. सर्डमा नि त्यो अवेक भन्ने एउटा प्रोजेक्ट छ नि, अहिले तपाईँले ख्याल गर्नुभयो होला, प्लाज्मा वेक फिल्ड एक्सेलरेटर भनेर. त्यसमा उनीहरूले चाहिँ सर्ट स्केलमा एक्सेलरेट गराउने भनेको छ. त्यसमा इन्भल्भ हुन पनि खोजेको, तर अब हाम्रो मेरो आफ्नो एक्सेलरेटरमा केही काम नगरेको हुनाले त्यसमा इन्भल्भ पनि भएको छैन, तर म अपडेट मात्रै गरेको छु. त्यसमा चाहिँ के छ, त्यसको प्रोस्पेक्ट अथवा फ्युचरमा त्यसले?
तर इफ यु निड मोर एनर्जी देन दिस एक्सेलरेटर, प्लाज्मा एक्सेलरेटर भनेको नै अर्को नेक्स्ट स्टेप हो होइन. यो चाहिँ फिजिकल एक्सिलेटर, प्लाज्मा एक्सिलेटर चाहिँ नर्मल कन्डक्टिङ क्याभिटिज कपर युज गरेर युज गर्ने, वेक फिल्ड एक्सिलेटर युज गर्ने भनेको नेक्स्ट जेनेरेसनको एक्सिलेटर हो, जसले चाहिँ योभन्दा पनि बढी इनर्जी प्रड्युस गर्न सक्छ. तर म आफू डिटेलमा काम नगरेको कारणले गर्दाखेरि डिटेलमा त भन्न सकिनँ मैले होइन, तर नेक्स्ट सिस्टम भनेको प्लाज्मा एक्सिलेटर
जस्तै मैले नि त्यसमा जस्तै म आफै प्लाज्मामा अब अर्कै एरियामा काम गरे पनि प्लाज्मामा गरेको हुनाले शङ्का गर्नुपर्ने त होइन, तर त्यो टाजिमाको 1979 कन्सेप्ट हो र उसको कन्सेप्टमा चाहिँ हामी एक्सेलेरेटरको अहिलेको साइजलाई घटाएर भनौँ न फ्यु अर्डर अफ भनेको 10 मिटर्सको अर्डरमै हामी त्यति इनर्जी निकाल्न सक्छौँ भनेको छ र यत्रो यदि त्यो सम्भव हुने भएदेखि त्यसमा चाहिँ अलि बढी इफोर्ट हुन्थ्यो कि भनेर अर्डिनरी अब फिजिक्स लेमेनले भनौँ न लेमेन त नभनौँ हामी अब त्यसमा काम नगर्ने मान्छेले शङ्का गर्ने कुरा भयो नि मैले भनेको बुझ्नु भयो कि बुझ्नु भएन, जस्तै 10 मिटर या 100 मिटरमा पनि सम्भव हुने भयो किन त्यसमा चाहिँ अलि बढी इफोर्ट लागेन भनेको हो, त्यसमा डिफिकल्टी चाहिँ के रहेछ, प्लाज्माकै कारणले हो कि अरू त्यसको इनरेन्ट केही प्रपर्टी छ कि? ओके तपाईँलाई मैले खालि क्वेसन मात्रै राखेँ तपाईँको फिल्ड होइन भन्दा भन्दै एनिवे अर्को अनिश दाहालजी उहाँले क्वेसन छ भन्नुभएको छ, अनिश क्यान यु प्लिज गो अहेड
सरलाई पशुपति सरलाई सुरुमा थ्याङ्क यू तपाईँको नाइस टकको लागि आज म जुट्ने मौका पाएँ, सबै सरहरूलाई पनि मेरो नमस्कार र यो अपर्च्युनिटीको लागि थ्याङ्क यू विनय सर स्पेसियल्ली। सर म भर्खर चाहिँ यो हाई टेम्परेचर सुपर कन्डक्टर कपर अक्साइड YBCO इटिएम बेरियम कपर अक्साइडमा काम गरिरहेको छु यो चाइना बेजिङतिर। अब सरले अघि त्यो सर्फेस रेजिस्टेन्स भनेर BCS थ्योरी रेजिस्टेन्स अनि रेजिडुअल रेजिस्टेन्स अनि फ्लक्स ट्र्यापको कुरा गर्नुभयो, त्यस्तै त्यो सरसँग केही आइडिया छ सर यो हाई टेम्परेचर सुपर कन्डक्टरमा रेजिस्टेन्स चाहिँ र नर्मल सुपर कन्डक्टरमा हुने रेजिस्टेन्सकोमा कस्तो फरक हुन्छ, अथवा हाई टेम्परेचरमा हामीले अलिक धेर प्रिकर्सन अपनाउनु पर्ने रेजिस्टेन्स रेन्जहरू के हुन सक्छ सर?
दुईटा कुरा हुन्छ, एउटा कुरा भनेको डिसी मेजरमेन्ट हो कि एसी मेजरमेन्ट हो त्यसमा भर पर्छ। डिसी मेजरमेन्ट भने कुनै केही खासै केही फरक पर्दैन किनकि तपाईँले डिसी मेजरमेन्ट गर्नुभयो भने आइभी कर्भ लिनुहोस् जतिखेर चाहिँ भोल्टेज ड्रप हुन्छ के अरे रेजिस्टेन्स जिरो आयो भने सकिहाल्यो डिसीको लागि। डिसीको लागि कस्तो भन्दा तपाईँको पुरै सुपर कन्डक्टर नै हुनु पर्दैन, एउटा पार्ट द करेन्ट निड टु फाइन्ड अ पाथ टु गो फ्रम वान साइड टु अनदर साइड, त्यो डिसी कुरा अब। तर एसी भनेपछि छुट्टै डिफ्रेन्ट भयो, अब एसी भनेपछि नै अब इट डिपेन्ड्स अन द नाउ अब स्किन डेप्थको कुरा आयो, फ्रिक्वेन्सी डिपेन्डेन्स अनि कति डेप्थसम्म एसी सिग्नल गएको छ, अनि अब यो त हाई फ्रिक्वेन्सी छ भने हाई फ्रिक्वेन्सी गिगा हर्ट्जको रेन्ज कुरा गऱ्यो भने ओन्ली कपल 100 नैनोमिटरमा मात्रै करेन्ट फ्लो हुन्छ, आरएफ करेन्ट फ्लो हुन्छ, त्यस कारणले गर्दाखेरि अनि त्यसपछि चाहिँ त्यो रेजिस्टेन्स चाहिँ एन्ड देन डिपेन्ड्स अन द सुपर कन्डक्टिङ ग्याप। सो त्यो सुपर कन्डक्टिङ ग्यापमा डिपेन्ड्स भएको विच इज बिसिएस रेजिस्टेन्स भनेको, बिसिएस रेजिस्टेन्सले पनि हाइटिसी सुपर कन्डक्टर एक्सप्लेन गर्दैन, बिसिएस इज ओन्ली फर द एलिमेन्टल सुपर कन्डक्टर विच हेभ द सिमेट्रिक ग्याप। सो बिसिएस आइटिसिएस सुपर कन्डक्टरको लागि त्यहाँ अलरेडी मान्छेको 10 जनाको 10 डिफ्रेन्ट थ्योरी छ, तर कन्क्लुजन के हो भन्दा यसको ग्याप सिमेट्रिक नभएको कारणले गर्दा सर्फेस रेजिस्टेन्स चाहिँ हाई हुन्छ त्यतिमा।
ओके थ्याङ्क यू सर।
ओके थ्याङ्क यू अनिशी। तपाईँ अहिले चाइनामै हो कि नेपालमा हुनुहुन्छ कि?
अहिले त नेपाल हो सर।
ओके ओके ल ठिक छ,
यतैबाट चल्दैछ सर अलिअलि।
त्यही त होइन जहाँ भए पनि यो
चाइनाको भनेको चाहिँ आइरन बेस हाइटिसी सुपर कन्डक्टर छ, आइरन बेस हाइटिसी सुपर कन्डक्टर चाहिँ इट मे बी अ एस वेभ सुपर कन्डक्टर मिन्स इट मे हेभ सम पोटेन्सियल युज, तर अहिलेसम्म हाइली कन्फर्म भइसकेको छैन, एस कसैले एस भन्छ कसैले पी भन्छ त्यस्तो छ।
ओके थ्याङ्क यू वान्स अगेन, सबै क्वेसन सोधिदिनु भयो, इन्टरेक्सन गरिदिनु भयो त्यसको लागि। र
म एउटा थपौँ राजु सर बिचमा अलिकति थोरै
पशुपतिजीलाई सोधेर थपौँ।
यो अर्को चाहिँ मेरो यो क्वेसन चाहिँ कोइन्चिङसँग रिलेटेड छ, यो एलएससी चाहिँ उद्घाटन गरे 2010 त्यतिखेर त्यो उद्घाटन गरेको 10-12 दिन पछाडि चाहिँ त्यो कोइन्चिङको प्रब्लम भएर सटडाउन गर्नु परेर छ होइन, त्यसो हुँदाखेरि यो नायोबियममा क्याभिटीमा चाहिँ त्यो लिक्विड हेलियमको फ्लो केही कारणले बन्द हुँदाखेरि क्वेन्चिङ हुने सम्भावना कतिको हुन्छ सर?
100% हुन्छ नि, त्यो त त्यही भएर कन्टिन्युसली 100 times नाइट यदि हिलियम फ्लो पनि हुनु पर्दैन, सम अदर कारणले गर्दा नि क्वेन्च हुनसक्छ। है विष्णुले क्वेसन सोधे जस्तो मिसिन कन्ट्रोलले चाहिँ उनीहरूलाई बिम दिएन एक्सपेरिमेन्ट गर्न लाग्यो भन्दा के भन्दा बिम सर्टेन डिरेक्सनमा डिफ्लेक्ट भयो अथवा भ्याकुम ट्रिप भयो भने पनि क्वेन्च हुन्छ होइन। त्यस कारणले गर्दाखेरि क्वेन्च समटाइम क्वेन्च क्यान रिकभर रियली फास्ट, समटाइम क्वेन्च डज नट रिकभर। त एलएससीको केसमा के हो भन्दा एलएससीले चाहिँ म्याग्नेट युज गरेको हो, म्याग्नेट इज मच मोर डेन्जरस देन द आरएफ पावर। अन्त आरएफ पनि डेन्जरस त हो तर मच मोर सेफ इन आरएफ क्याभिटिज। अब म्याग्नेटमा चाहिँ एक्चुली यु हेभ टु रन द करेन्ट, करेन्टै रन गरेर अनि म्याग्नेट क्वेन्च हुने हो, त्यो भनेको पुरै हिट प्रड्युस हुन्छ। हाम्रोमा क्वेन्च भनेको आरएफ पावर मात्रै हो, हाम्रो हाम्रो आरएफ पावरले चाहिँ गर्न त ब्याड थिङ नै गर्छ तर इट्स नट एज ब्याड एज द एलएससी।
ओके, ब्रस हुने नै त्यस्तो एक्सप्लोसिभ हुने सम्भावना चाहिँ हुन्न सर?
त्यस्तो सम्भावना धेरै कम हुन्छ।
ओके, थ्याङ्क यू।
हाम्रो चाहिँ आरएफ पावर हो, तिनीहरूको चाहिँ डिसी करेन्टै युज गरेर हुन्छ।
ओके,
अब अरू क्वेरीहरू सबै आइसक्यो, 9:12 पनि भयो, त्यहाँ त 11:30 भयो होला, 11:30 लगभग 11:30 भयो होला। थ्याङ्क यू सो मच डाक्टर पशुपति ढकाल। म एकचोटि हेड सरलाई ट्राई गर्छु, विनिल सर। ओके विनिल सर, अघि मलाई मेसेजमा लेख्नु भएको थियो, च्याटमा पनि लेख्नु भएको थियो, मेरो इमर्जेन्सी काम परे जस्तो छ, म निस्किन सक्छु भन्नुहुन्थ्यो। त्यसैले एकचोटि फेरि डाक्टर पशुपति ढकाललाई, यो हामी सबैलाई विशेष गरी स्टुडेन्टहरूलाई र हामी यो इभन फ्रन्टियरमा काम गरिरहेको साथीहरू जस्तै मेदनी सम्बुजी निर्मलजीहरूलाई पनि युजफुल हुने गरी प्रेजेन्टेसन गरिदिनुभयो, एकदम धेरै धेरै धन्यवाद। र डेफिनेटली अघि सुरुमा हाम्रो कुरा भयो जस्तै हामी यो इन्टरेक्सनलाई चाहिँ अब उयो भनौँ न नराम्रोको राम्रो भने जस्तै कोभिडको उपहार सम्झेर यसलाई पछि पनि कन्टिन्यू गर्नुपर्छ। महिनामा एकचोटि सकिन्छ कि अब हप्तामा एकचोटि सकिन्छ कि दिनमा एकचोटि सकिन्छ अथवा के फिजिबल र इफेक्टिभ हुन्छ त्यो अनुसार यसलाई पछि पनि डेफिनेटली कन्टिन्यू गर्नुहुन्छ। हामी डिपार्टमेन्टबाटै पनि त्यो हामी गर्न सक्छौँ, अहिले नेटको हाम्रो नेपालमा पनि अहिले हामी देखिरहेछौँ यति धेरै स्टुडेन्टहरू छन् अनलाइन क्लासहरू भइरहेछ र डिपार्टमेन्टबाटै पनि हामी कनेक्ट गर्छौँ। खालि टाइम चाहिँ त्यही अनुसारले तपाईँहरूलाई पनि ढिलो नहुने हामीलाई पनि ढिलो नहुने अथवा विकेन्ड जस्तो पारेर गर्नुपर्छ। एकचोटि फेरि विशेष धन्यवाद डाक्टर ढकाललाई र अरू सबै जो जो उपस्थित हुनुभयो जापानदेखि युएससम्म भनेको होल ग्लोबबाट तपाईँलाई धन्यवाद। र अब यसलाई हेडसर नभएको हुनाले मैले अफिसियल्ली नै यसलाई नाउ द सेमिनार अफिसियल सेमिनार फर टुडे इज ओभर। र अघि सुरुमा रुद्रजीले भने हुनाले कसैलाई केही झलफल गफ गर्नु छ भने र निन्द्रा लागेको छैन भने है यो अलिक टाढा भयो हुन चाहिँ भोलि शनिबार हो तपाईँहरूलाई, नाउ वी आर फ्री टु डिस्कस एनिथिङ।
तपाईँहरूलाई हेरेर गर्नुहोस् भन्नुपर्छ होइन, किप वर्किङ। तर धेरै जस्तो यहाँ फेमिलियर फेस पनि छ, फेमिलियर कति नयाँ पनि हुनुहुन्छ होइन, धेरै अगाडिदेखि त गर्न मन लागेको थियो, नेपाल जाँदा टाइम हुँदैन, यहाँबाट आउँदा यस्तै हो,
कोरोनाले जुराइदियो, राम्रो
कोरोनाले जुराइदियो। तर धेरै धेरै धन्यवाद। अनि अरू अनि विनिन सरले चाहिँ बेला बेलामा युट्युब भिडियो गरेपछि नि अलिकति टेम्पटिङ भयो क्या, गरौँ गरौँ भन्ने लाग्यो कि,
त्यही त रुद्रको निर्मलको हाम्रो भिडियो आइसक्यो
अनि गर्नै पर्छ भनेर के अरे ल नि त ल गरौँ भनेर गरेको। त्यसको लागि मलाई यो प्लेटफर्म दिनुभएकोमा धेरै धेरै धन्यवाद। अरू यहाँ युएसमा भएको भएको साथीहरूको सम्म त हाम्रो बेला बेलामा कन्ट्याक्ट भइरहेको छ, हाम्रो एन्पामा सम हाउ पार्टिसिपेट भएको कारणले गर्दा हाम्रो अपकमिङ कन्फरेन्स आउँदैछ, यहाँ सबैजनाहरू पार्टिसिप जे भए पनि ट्युन इन गर्नु होला, जुलाई 17-19 एक्चुअली त्यसको चेयर चेयर भए भएर राम्रो 50% त कन्डेन्स म्याटर मात्रै छ त्यसमा, नेपालबाट राम्रो पार्टिसिपेन्ट भइरहेको छ। सो
पहिले हामी पढ्दा तपाईँ पढ्दा पनि त्यही थियो होला, हामी पढ्दा तपाईँलाई याद छ कि छैन इलेक्टिभ सब्जेक्टमा एउटा मात्रै सब्जेक्ट थियो कन्डेन्स म्याटर इलेक्ट्रोनिक्स थियो सरी हरिजी हरिजी फेरि इलेक्ट्रोनिक्स पनि थियो तर हाम्रोमा
हरि सरलाई पोखरा पठाइदिएपछि मिश्र सरको सोलिसिटर मात्रै मागेको थियो
त्यही त अनि त्यो त अल्टिमेटली कन्डेन्स म्याटर मात्रै मागेको थियो
तर अमेरिकन सँगै तपाईँ छोडेर
जानुभयो आफ्नो जब कन्टिन्यू गर्नु पर्यो सबै बस्नु भएन
अमेरिका त सर एउटै फ्लाइट हो नि हाम्रो
तिमी त कोरियासँगको साथी हो नि
ओके मैले अघि नै भने थ्याङ्क यू पशुपतिजी थ्याङ्क यू भनेपछि यो फर्मल भयो अब हामी जसलाई जे जे मन लाग्छ हेड सरले अब कहाँ जानुभयो छोडेर हामीले आनन्दै भयो
हजुर पशुपतिजीको चाहिँ आजको टक चाहिँ मेरो एउटा इलेक्ट्रोडाइनामिक्स क्लासलाई ठ्याक्कै फिट हुने भयो म तपाईँको भिडियो आएपछि त्यो मल्टिपल टाइम्स मेरो स्टुडेन्टहरूले हेर्छन् है अब आउने
एउटा कुरा बिचमा मैले सोधिहालेँ यो हाम्रो हेड सरले भिडियो अन गर्नु भएको छ उहाँ अहिले एक्टिभ हुनुहुन्न यसलाई स्टप गर्ने केही तरिका छ यो पछि हामी बोलेको काटौँला एडिट गरौँला तर रेकर्डमै किन धेर गर्ने उहाँले गरेको हुनाले उहाँले मात्रै अफ गर्न सक्नुहुन्छ कि क्या
ए
मेरोमा त्यो अप्सन देखाएन भनेको
सरले
छोडेर